Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Merry Christmas. I'm sorry for that technical hitch. We will proceed. I would like to take this opportunity to welcome you to our midweek service. I'm Reverend James Mureke, and I love the Lord as my personal Savior. We are going to get our text from the Gospel according to St. Matthew, chapter 3, verse 1 to 12. And I will read. The topic or the title of the reading is John the Baptist Prepares the Way. In those days, John the Baptist came preaching in the desert of Judea and saying, "Repent, for the kingdom of heaven is near." This is he who was spoken of through the prophet Isaiah, "A voice of one calling in the desert, prepare the way for the Lord, make straight paths for him." John's clothes were made of camel's hair, and he had a leather belt around his waist. His food was locusts and wild honey. People went out to him from Jerusalem and the whole Judea and the whole region of the Jordan. Confessing their sins, they were baptized by him in the Jordan River. But when he saw many of the Pharisees and the Sadducees coming to where he was baptizing, he said to them, "You brood of vipers, who warned you to flee from the coming wrath? Produce fruit in keeping with repentance. And do not think you can say to yourselves, 'We have Abraham as our father.' I tell you that out of these stones, God can raise up children to Abraham. The axe is already at the root of the trees, and every tree that does not produce good fruit will be cut down and thrown into the fire. I baptize you with water for repentance, but after me will come one who is more powerful than I, whose sandals I am not fit to carry. He will baptize you with the Holy Spirit and with the fire. His winnowing fork is in his hand, and he will clear his threshing floor, gathering his wheat into the barn and burning up the chaff with an unquenchable fire." Let us pray. Our dear Lord, we come before thy presence this evening as we celebrate together your mighty acts. You have carried us through from January to this time, Lord, that we are approaching the end of the year. Welcome thy presence in our midst, wherever your servants, your people are watching from, so that, Lord, you may speak to us in a language that, Lord, each one of us will understand. In Jesus' name we do pray. Amen. Brothers and sisters, one of the marks of an excellent leader is how he or she brings about transformation in people and organizations that he or she leads. John the Baptist performed this role very well as he prepared the Jewish people for Jesus. Since this Messiah would be very different from what everyone expected, John had to get the people ready for this radical shift. John prepared the people for Jesus' ministry with a unique ministry of his own, courageously calling people to repent and live out what they claimed to believe. For over 2,000 years, Jesus Christ was born to save mankind from the sin. And over the years, we have been celebrating his birthday in different styles. This week, as we all know, we are all in that mode of Christmas, planning on how we can go about it, in what to eat, what to drink, the clothes that we can wear, the new places that we can visit, and the new friends or the old friends that we can meet, and so on and so forth. Christians have joined the non-Christians to work so hard to deviate the purpose or reason why Jesus was born. To many, it is no longer the season to reflect about the purpose of his birth and meditate upon it. To others, it's no longer the time to reflect about your relationship with God and other people. To the rest, it is no longer the season to show compassion to the less fortunate in the society. And also, it is no longer a fellowship, a meeting together and sharing the word of God together. It is no longer the day of appreciation and thanksgiving. Back to our text, the Gospel of St. Matthew, chapter 3, verse 1 to 12. In verse 2, John says that, "Repent, for the kingdom of heaven is near." Brothers and sisters, repentance is not merely a change of mind, but a radical change in one's life as a whole that especially involves forsaking sin and returning or returning to God. Dr. Luke, in his Gospel, chapter 3, verse 3 to 6, he quotes Prophet Isaiah, chapter 4, verse 3 to 6, where he prophesied that one would come to make straight paths for the Lord. He says, "Every valley shall be filled in, every mountain and hill shall be made low. The crooked roads shall become straight." This means that in order for the people to receive the salvation which Christ was to bring, the valleys, that is whatever was lacking spiritually, such as faith, love, patience, self-control, and others, must be filled up. Obstructions in the way, in the journey of faith, like mountains and hills, that is pride, hatred, idolatry, jealousy, self-confidence, and selfishness, all these must be made low. Those walking in the crooked roads must return to straight paths. Only then will all mankind see God's salvation. Salvation would have been given not only to the Jews, but also to the non-Jews. Salvation was given to all men and women who have prepared their hearts by repenting and by turning to Christ in faith. The preparation was to be moral and spiritual. True repentance is an inward reorientation, affecting the whole of one's thoughts, but it expresses itself in an outward act. in repentance, one turns away from idolatry, sin, or evils, or wrongdoing, and any other way of life that is contrary to God's word, which is a lamp to our feet and a light to our path. When John the Baptist began baptizing, many people, that is Pharisees and Sadducees, also came to him for baptism. The Pharisees were a very strict party of the Jews. They prided themselves on strictly following the Jewish law. The Sadducees were the second main party of the Jews. Most of the Jewish chief priests were Sadducees. The two groups were leaders among the Jewish people. Yet, John called them brood of vipers when they came to be baptized. He called them brood of vipers because they were hypocrites. They were religious outwardly, but not inwardly. They were honored. They honored God with their lips, but not with their hearts. That is according to the Gospel, according to St. Mark, chapter 7, verse 6 to 7. They thought that by being baptized, they could escape God's wrath. That is God's judgment. This is exactly how some of the Christians of today behave. They think that being baptized and given an English name, they will escape the wrath of God. Being born and brought up in a Christian environment will save them from the Lord's judgment. Or being a regular church in Goa, giving tithes, offertories, will be a ticket for eternity. No. John knew that these people were not truly repentant. They did not really intend to turn from their sins. They were only baptized to show others how religious they were. They were like brood of vipers. Matthew chapter 12, verse 34, and chapter 23, verse 33. They were crafty and deceitful. They were also poisonous. There is nothing so poisonous, brethren, to the church as leaders or members who pretend to be religious outwardly, but who inwardly are brood of vipers. This is still the kind of people who are waiting for the birth of Jesus in any style that they wish. People who are proud because of their big positions in the government and the other corporate world. People who have godfathers are not God the Father. People who have no regard to human life. They can do anything to get whatever they want. People who are stealing from the citizens, other citizens, in a broad daylight through corruption and other queer ways. Jewish leaders despised non-Jews. That is Gentiles. They thought to themselves, we are the true descendants of Abraham, the first Jew. God has promised us he will bless us, according to Genesis chapter 12, verse 1 to 3. Therefore, we are better than others. We are better than other people. We have found favor with God. But John warned them. He warned them that being a descendant of Abraham, according to the flesh, was not important to God. Just as God created the first man out of the dust of the ground, according to Genesis chapter 2, verse 7, so God can create children of Abraham out of stones. What is important to God is that a man be a true Jew in his heart, not just in body. A true Jew, a true Christian, is one who does the will of God and who puts his faith in God's only Son, Jesus Christ. In Luke chapter 3, verse 10 to 14, the Jews asked John, "What should we do then?" In verse 11 of the same book and the chapter, John answered that they should do the works of love. They should love their neighbor. You should show compassion to the less fortunate. If you love your neighbor, you can't steal from him or her. If you love Kenyans, if you love other Kenyans, you cannot steal from them. Verse 12 and 13, the tax collectors also came to him and asked, "Teacher, what should we do?" He told them, "Don't collect any more than you are required to." Most of tax collectors cheated the people, and as a result, the people hated them and considered them great sinners. Even today, this happens. I've heard over the media where some county government or revenue collectors have been attacked by the public because of overcharging them. You are told today, don't collect any more than you are required. John didn't tell them to stop collecting taxes because it was not a sin, but he told them to be honest. Be honest, brothers and sisters. Be honest with the public resources. Be honest with yourself. Be honest with the little and the much the Lord has entrusted you with, either in his church or in any other organization. John gave the same kind of advice to the soldiers. I'm wondering, because some of these things that we see practiced today by some of the uniformed officers started a long time ago, even before Christ. These soldiers were Jewish soldiers in the service of Herod the Tetrarch of Galilee. These are the three things John said to them. One, don't extort money. Two, don't accuse people falsely, because that's the work of the police. That's what most of them do. And three, be content with your pay or your salary. That is, do not complain or seek extra advantages for yourself. These ones apply to all of us, not to soldiers only, brothers and sisters. Brethren, we need to celebrate the birth of our Lord Jesus Christ in a way that it will bear fruits for the kingdom of God. This is because, as we heard from the text, the axe is already at the root of the trees, and every tree that does not produce good fruit will be cut down and thrown into the fire. We need to produce fruit in keeping with repentance. You can't serve two masters at the same time. May the Lord help us to bear good fruits that are worthy his kingdom. The fruits that will attract many to Christ who was born in our hearts. Tumesherehekea kuzaliwa kwa mwokozi wetu Yesu Kristo kwa miaka mingi. Lakini wengine wetu tunabaki pale pale bila mabadiliko yoyote ndani ya mioyo yetu. Limekuwa jambo la kawaida, jambo la kula na kunywa na kuvaa na kujiburundisha kwa aina yoyote kwa kiwango cha hata mwagikaji wa damu. Wakristo, tunapaswa tujirudie na tumkaribishe Yesu ndani ya mioyo yetu. Na kila nawatakia Krismasi yenye baraka na mwaka mpya wa 2021 wenye mafanikio. Katika jina la Yesu, la Mungu Baba Mwana na Roho Mtakatifu. Amina. Na tuombe. Baba uliye mkuu na muweza yote, tunakuja mbele zako jioni ya leo tukikushukuru na kulitukuza jina lako takatifu kwa yale Bwana umetenda katika maisha yetu. Ulianza mwaka nazi na tukapitia mambo mengi Bwana katika maisha yetu. Lakini Bwana tunasema ni asante kwa mahali umetufikisha. Zimebaki siku chache tuone mwaka mpya. Na tunaomba Bwana uendelee kutulinda na kutuongoza na utuwezeshe kuona huo mwaka tukiwa chini ya ulinzi wako. Wiki hii Bwana tunaendelea kusherekea vile Bwana ulikuja katika dunia hii kwa ajili yetu. Tunaomba Bwana mioyo yetu isongee karibu na wewe, ili Bwana tupate kukaribisha ndani ya mioyo yetu, ili tupate kuzaliwa upya katika maisha yetu. Tuomba Roho wako Mtakatifu endelee kutuongoza na kutulinda tunapojiandaa kwa hiyo sherehe ya kukumbuka vile Bwana ulisaliwa, na tukukaribishe katika roho zetu, katika matendo yetu, kwa yale yote ambayo tutaendelea kuyatenda na kutafakari, yawe Bwana yanaambatana na ufalme wako. Kaa nasi, utulinde na utuongoze kwa yote, na uendelee kutubariki katika kila hali ya maisha yetu. Katika jina la Yesu Kristo tunaomba na kuamini. Amina. Bwana awabariki.